Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding with Tea. Today we are going to learn consumer stateful widget, which is kind of similar to the stateful widget in Flutter, but it's going to add other features of Riverpod with our stateful widget. And in this, definitely we are going to manage the cycle of a widget on init, on dispose. As you can see, currently we are creating the fourth video of our Riverpod state management, and the previous video is already created. I'll drop the link down below in the description of this complete playlist. If you're new, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. And if you learn something in this video, make sure to like it. Okay, so without wasting time, let's get started. Over here, as I explained in the previous video, that we are going to add each tutorial in a separate folder so that you can easily get the playlist link, which is a GitHub link, and you can download the complete code. I'll make sure that I have to update all of this. So video one is this, in which we learn the simple provider, what is consumer widget, how can we use using ref.watch, and we also learn the ref.read. And also in the video two, we learn how to create state provider. We change the state, we created a counter provider or the counter widget, and we learn how we are going to increment using on press event. So over here you can see we are using the reference.read, and also we use reference.watch. We learn how to use the consumer widget, so we do not have to rebuild the whole widget again and again. Rather, we can only use this consumer to rebuild this specific text only. So if you're new, again, you can watch the previous videos. I'll drop the link in the description, or you can also get it from the right top corner. So for the third video, I have another folder with a video on it. So not the video, it's a dart file. So let's start today's tutorial. So first of all, I'm going to create stateful widget. Just have to write stf, and it is going to show you a short form. So hit on it and stateful widget will be created. Let's write the name. I'm just going to name it tutorial 4, or you can name it as stateful consumer widget tutorial, something like that. So I change the name to stateful consumer tutorial. Okay, now first of all, if we go to the video 2, what is the difference between consumer widget and consumer stateful widget? So if we talk about the consumer widget, and let's say we need a text field inside this design, so what I have to do inside the build method, I have to usually create, because in this Riverpod, you see, so far we didn't learn anything about controllers. We do not have a controller over here which is going to manage the lifecycle, so that we can create or initialize our text editing controller, then we can dispose text editing controller, so that there should be no memory leaks when we do not want that controller. So these kind of cases, if we're going to handle them in the consumer widget, so let's say I'm going to create email text editing controller. So let's say email is equal to text editing controller. So by this way, email will be created, and inside the text field we're going to assign this email to that specific text field. But the issue is, whenever this build method is going to redraw, or no matter how many times it is going to redraw, this text editing controller will be reassigned with the new values, and all the previous text editing controllers will definitely go into the memory, and we will have a memory leak. So it is a very bad approach, and definitely you cannot even use that. If the widget is going to be redraw, all the data will be vanished. So same like if you're going to use the animations, you have to use the mixins, and if you want to use the mixin, you have to manage the state. For that, you again need on init, on dispose kind of events. So you don't want to again have memory leaks, or you do not want to let the animations keep on running in the background, even the screen is not visible. So that is definitely going to impact our performance. So we are not going to do anything like this. So rather, we have the stateful widget. So I'm going to change the stateful widget with the consumer stateful widget. So this is how we are going to create. Once we change these things, we have to change this state to consumer state, and also this state as well to consumer state, because you see, previously it was stateful widget, so that's why we have the state only. But now, as it is consumer stateful widget, so we have to use this consumer state at these two locations as well. Now what we want to do in this specific tutorial, or in this specific screen, we want to create a provider, and whenever the value of that specific text editing controller that we are going to use inside this class, so whenever the text editing controller is going to change, we want to redraw or update our specific Riverpod provider as well. Okay, so I have added the scaffold with the padding. App bar is just an app bar column. We have a text form field over here, then some space, and then this is the text which we want to update. So whenever we are going to write anything in this text field, we want to make sure that this text should also be updated. So first of all, let me run this application in the Chrome. You can run it in the mobile app, but because I have also added the web module while while creating this project so I can run it in the Chrome as well. Okay, our application is running, but this is the previous tutorial. So in the main.dart, we have to change this to consumer, stateful consumer tutorial. Let's rerun it again. And this time you can see we have an app bar and we have a text field. So whenever we are going to write anything over here, we should be able to get that text inside this text field. First of all, I'm going to create a provider over here, the provider that we learned in the previous tutorial. So this provider is going to change the values. So it will be a state provider. So text provider is equal to, you know, we have to write state provider, and in each provider, because each provider is a function, so we have to create a function, and you know, we need a ref object in this function. And now from here, we are going to return as an initial text an empty string. So it is a text provider. We want to use that. Remember that we are now using consumer stateful widget, and you might have asked, or you might be thinking about that we have the build context, but we do not have any ref object, right? In the stateful consumer widget, we do not need the ref object because that ref object is already integrated over here, so we can easily use that ref object wherever we want. So inside the build method, I'm going to get that text as text is equal to, you see by default we have that ref object already integrated, so we have to use ref.watch again because we have to change the text, so we need to watch instead of read. Name of the provider is text provider. So now we have that text over here, and we want to make sure that this text should be printed inside this text field. So whenever there is change in the text provider, this text will be changed and we will get our widget updated. Again, if you want to only update this text, remember the previous tutorial, you just have to wrap this text with a consumer and not a consumer widget, but a consumer only. It is also a widget and will help you to only update this text. But for this example, I'm going to go for this provider only. Okay, now we need a text controller, a text editing controller that we can use over here because it's a stateful widget. So outside this build method, we can easily create any type of variable. So I have final text editing controller, and it is late because we do not want to initialize it at this stage. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to utilize its built-in lifecycle methods. So we are going to use initState first of all when the application runs. So first call super.initState, and then it is the time to initialize controller. And over here inside this same function, we are going to listen for any changes. Now first of all, to initialize the controller, we have controller is equal to text editing controller, and this init will only execute once when this widget will be created. So once the widget is created, we have assigned the text editing controller, and also once this controller is assigned, we want to create a listener on this controller, controller.addListener. So again, it is a function, add semicolon, and inside this function we want to update this text provider. We want to change this text because whenever there is change in this controller, or user is going to write anything in this controller or remove it, so the value of this controller will be changed. So it is going to trigger this function. So whenever this function is going to trigger, we want to update our value of text provider. So we learn that how we are going to update the values. So reference.read, because we only want to update the value once, we do not want to watch it. So name of the provider, text provider, and again because we have to notify with a new value, so we have to call the notifier. This time we have a state which is a string, and want to update it whatever we have inside controller.text. So we want to get this text from here, assign that in the state. So this, by this way, state will be updated. And we have to now do one last thing inside this text field. We have controller option and assign that controller over here. Now let's save this code. Okay, our application is running, and let's try to write something. You see, Riverpod, you can name it crash course. So whatever we are writing, it is automatically being changed in the text below. Sorry for the spelling. So by this way, you see, we have all the things easily managed. We have the init state. We are using this state to assign values, and also we have another state that is, again, we are going to use control O to override, and you have to search for dispose method. We are going to again override the dispose, first call super dot dispose, and then we are going to dispose this controller, controller dot dispose. You can swap it, keep it at the top, and then dispose the overall widget. So this is how we can utilize the cycle functions or the cycle features of any widget by using consumer stateful widget. So it will act like a stateful widget by this way. way, what we are going to achieve, we will be able to easily distribute the logic of UI design. Okay, I've created another example using consumer stateful widget so that you can understand it better. So at the top, you can see I've created a duration provider. So this is not a state provider. This is a simple provider that is not going to change the values. We just need to get the duration from this. So if you want to simplify any provider, just change it with the fat arrows, remove the semicolon and the brackets. Do not need return type over here. You can write it this way. And also, if you do not need this ref object, you can replace it with underscore. And it is quite simple as this. So it is a simple provider that we learn in the second tutorial of this playlist. We have the duration provider. Reference.read is going to read that duration one time. So we have the duration. And then we have the animation controller. Remember that we have a let over here. We need to initialize it in the init method. Vsync duration. Not going to go into details of animation. I talked about the animations in my previous videos. Again, if you need, I'll share the link. And also we need to dispose it. And in the build method, you can see I have an app bar pulsing circle, which is change the circle. And then we have the scale transition. Scale is going to use the animation controller dot drive. We are going using the tween. So it will remain between 0.5 to 1.5 in scale. So it is going to go as small as 0.5 and large as 1.5. So it will return back to 0.5. So this is the animation. And again, this is the circle that we want to animate. So let me run this application. And you can see we have a circle which is being changing its values. So whenever we're going to close the screen or remove the screen using dispose, this animation controller will be closed. We are efficiently handling all the leaks. We are not letting any animation keep on running when the user interface is not in front of the screen. So I hope you learned something new. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions, you can ask me down below in the comments. And just a quick recap, consumer widget is a stateless widget and there is no life cycle involved in that. But stateful consumer widget or consumer stateful widget is actually contains a life cycle of the widget. It has init method, dispose method, and definitely we can use all the features of Riverpod using ref access. So it is perfect when we will talk about the controllers, animations, any local state that needs cleanup when the design is gone. So by this way, we will keep the logic where it belongs. Backend will remain separate. User interface will again remain separate. So in the next tutorial, which is the video 5 or the tutorial 5 of this course, we are going to learn that how to handle asynchronous data. We will learn the future provider and how to fetch data from remote JSON or from remote database or using some API. So that tutorial is going to be amazing. If you learn something new, please like the video. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching and take care.